We are here with John Stankey of WarnerMedia, making some news this morning, literally just in the past hour, that you're going to be offering a direct-to-consumer offering package that's going to be led by HBO, but going to have a lot of other content around it. This is going to be in 2019.
That's correct. Fourth quarter 2019. You know, we're responding to what customers want, which is they want to be able to watch their content wherever they are, whenever they can. And we've got such a great library of popular content within the WarnerMedia families. It's a great opportunity for us to take remarkable strength of HBO, put it out front, and then surround it with not only great WarnerMedia content that's been built up over the years, but some select third-party licensed content as well. We think it's going to be an incredibly
compelling offer. But to put a fine point on it, is this what might be described as like an HBO Plus program? The reason I say that is you can buy HBO separately, but you won't be able to buy this package without HBO.
You can buy HBO separately, and that will still continue to be the case. And this additional offer, to be meaningful and in the market in the right way, you'll have to buy it with other product and service like HBO, yes.
And this is clearly a reaction, though, obviously to the might and heft of what Netflix has, and I imagine what Disney's about to do.
I think it's a reaction to a reality that customers, you know, demand that they see their content this way. And yes, there's other very capable competitors out there putting great vehicles for consuming content and user-friendly interfaces in a dynamic fashion. And we think, you know, when we've got this great portfolio of distribution capabilities today from wireless, pay TV, what we're able to do with some of our virtual over-the-top products, this is just yet one more tool in the toolbox.
Can you give
us
some sense on pricing? ESPN Plus is only $4.99, and you have Netflix, you know, in a sort of $11 to $14 range. HBO right now is somewhere in the $15 range, depending on where you are. This obviously, I would imagine, has to be more expensive.
I think we're going to do this dance for the next year where everybody's going to ask what's the price and what's the content. I'm going to say we'll tell you right before we launch, but I will tell you, obviously, if you're getting HBO Plus something, you should expect it's going to be selling at a retail price that'll be something more expensive right. than HBO today.
Okay, let me ask you a different question. It's a branding issue. So this is not, as I called it, I just called it HBO Plus, and that was not pre-planned. Why create what I imagine will become a separate brand as opposed to funneling this content through an HBO branded franchise?
Well, we think brands are really important, and HBO is a classic case of that. It's a brand that stands for something that people immediately recognize what you're getting when you are an HBO. And that portfolio of what the brand stands for fits a broad audience, but it's a particular type of content. And one of the things that we think is different about our offering and needs to be different moving forward is we don't want kind of a warehouse approach to it. We want a collection of brands that customers look at and say, I know exactly what I'm getting when I go to that part of the
user interface. So is this the new bundle?
This is a new bundle. It's a way to think about a bundle, correct. And how do you get the right brands together in an on-demand world?
And how much of this content is going to be new, meaning you're going to have additional investment in new content, not just in additional investment in perhaps HBO content, but in some of these other brands?
You're going to have a combination of new and library. Our initial launch right now will be very emphasis on library. But you should expect that as we think about the WarnerMedia family and the different platforms we have, our investment in content, which is substantial every year, over $10 billion amongst the families, we'll be choosing which platforms we put things on and what right. new stuff appears where.
We were just on stage at the Vanity Fair Conference, and I had asked you whether CNN was going to be a part of this, and you said no. Why not?
Well, CNN does some documentary work that will very much be a part of the on-demand library. But as I said earlier, our initial step in this direction is an on-demand service, so a switch video on-demand type of product that people refer to. Do I believe that over time we'll start to see these technologies allow us to do a combination of live linear and on-demand, and they'll morph together in user interfaces that add more value to the customer? I do, but that's not our first step at this point.
How do you measure success? Meaning 2-3 years out, how many new subscribers do you need on the direct-to-consumer platform?
Well, we're not publicly disclosing our subscriber counts or our business plan around it, but what I would tell you is our objective with this is we want to have a relationship with the vast majority of households in the United States at some point in time. And so we expect this product to be a key element of getting into customer households that we don't have a relationship with today.